is going on, and welcome back to What Shall We Do Next. I'm Mike, your host, and I hope you guys are having the best day ever. Before I get started, guys, if you are new here, please subscribe if you haven't already done that. We're on the road to 94,000 subscribers, and I would love you to join me on this journey. So hit subscribe and join the fam. And also, guys, go follow me on all my social media. Links are in the description. I have Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and even Snapchat, so go follow me on all of those. And as you guys know, I recently started a Facebook account, so you can add me on Facebook and we can be Facebook friends, so go do that. Link is in the description. And finally, be sure to turn on the notification bell right next to the subscribe button, that way you get notified every time I upload a video. Thank you. But once again, I am coming back at you guys with another creepy video, and today we are talking about another creepy pasta. And this creepy pasta is called MortalKombat.exe. But enough of the jibber jabber, let's get right over to the story. MortalKombat.exe. The select screen for MortalKombat.exe. I've always been a fan of Mortal Kombat games, especially the Mortal Kombat Project games, but not anymore. In fact, I hate even hearing about the game. One day, I was surfing the web for some games, and I happened to come across a game called MortalKombat.exe. I'm not going to give out the link for your safety and your computer's safety, but anyways, I thought it would be boring and dull. But when I looked at the RAM it took up, it said it takes 2 gigabytes. So I thought to myself that the game would be exciting, because I've never downloaded a Mortal Kombat game that took up so much memory. So I clicked on the download link and started downloading the game. Surprisingly, it took over 4 hours for the entire game to download. The download then finished, but that's when things started to get weird. The download box popped up, letting me know that the download was finished, so I clicked run, and then my laptop screen burst into static and started playing a high-pitched frequency sound. Then the laptop literally just went black. I grunted to myself in anger, trying to turn on the laptop again. After a few tries, my laptop finally came back on, the same as it was before, except there was the game on my desktop. I thought to myself that the laptop probably just crashed from the large download. So I clicked on the game and it started playing. There was no music playing. The screen showed Goro and there were the words arcade, versus, practice, options, and exit. So I clicked arcade and the Mortal Kombat arcade theme burst out of my speakers violently, nearly shaking my whole house. So I quickly muted my computer, thinking nothing of the sound. And what came up, I couldn't believe. The character selection screen came up, showing a total of 276 characters. I was amazed. This was the best Mortal Kombat game ever. So I selected one of my favorite characters, which is Chameleon. Only there were 6 versions of him. So I chose the Mortal Kombat Trilogy Chameleon. Then a box popped up on the selection screen saying, choose stage. There was a total of 500 stages, only making the game better. So I chose my favorite place to fight, the Mortal Kombat 1 pit. When I selected the stage, a voice said, good choice, Lane. 2 things then popped up into my head. 1, how did he know my name? And 2, how is his voice coming through my speakers when they're muted? Then the loading screen came up. I had to fight Hydra, a Mortal Kombat Project character. So I started fighting and finally got to the point where the voice said, finish him. Then a box popped up showing a list of names. One of my friend's names, Jordan. So I clicked Jordan just for fun. And then another box came up saying, choose Fatality. Then a box popped up saying Fatality 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and Stage Fatality. I thought that it was awesome that every character had 10 fatalities and a stage finisher, so I chose stage fatality. When I clicked stage fatality, it showed my character, Chameleon, uppercutting Hydro, causing him to fall into the pit's spikes at the bottom. When he hit the ground, very realistic blood shot out of him as he screamed in agony. But Hydro's scream nearly broke my speakers, it was that loud. I was angry that I kept hearing noises from the game, as I'd muted my computer and confused as to why the noises were so loud. Then the words, "Chameleon wins fatality," came up on the screen, but there was no voice saying the name in fatality. Then the voice came up saying, "You will never win, Lane." And I mean loud. Then a bunch of pop-ups saying MortalKombat.exe is not responding came up, crashing my laptop. I was frightened. I tried to turn on the laptop, but it would not power on. I thought that it must have been a virus. Angrily, I put my laptop down, thinking to myself that I could try and fix it in the morning since I'm good with computers. I then went to bed, trying to sleep, but still thinking about why the game knew my name. I awoke to a ringing noise. It was my iPhone 4. I looked at my phone to check what time it was, and it was 2:30 a.m. I answered the phone only to hear my friend's mom crying. I asked her to tell me what was wrong and what the siren sound was in the background. She told me that the sirens were police and ambulance sirens, and that Jordan was dead. He had several large holes in his body. I bolted down the stairs trying to turn on my laptop, but then a message popped up saying, "Thank you for playing, Lane, but I told you you will never win." I was screaming and crying in horror and despair as several message boxes popped up saying never. Then the worst thing ever happened to me. A bunch of pictures of dead adults, children, and babies popped up on the screen. Then a message box popped up saying, "Look at him." Then a picture of my friend Jordan was shown. His eyes gouged out and his intestines popped out laying on the floor. He also had several gory holes in his body. The screen went black and a Mortal Kombat font came up saying, "Lane wins fatality." The screen then went black. This is a reconstruction of the last screen that Lane would have ever seen. It has been 4 months since the incident, and I am traumatized by it, just like anybody else would be. The police found the man who killed Jordan. Oddly, he's the creator of the game I downloaded. Yesterday, I was flipping through the channels on my TV, and I saw Jordan's killer in court on a TV show. I had to watch. After about 5 minutes, the judge asked him what he had to say before he was sentenced to death. He responded by looking at the camera and saying, "Lane, you will never win," violently laughing as the bailiff carried him away.
And that is the end of that. So I hope you guys enjoyed this story. It's pretty cool, pretty creepy, pretty different. I've heard stories that are similar to this, like that Barbie.exe, I think it is, or Barbie.avi. I love these things that remind me kind of like the dark web. Like this is like stuff that you've downloaded, and you know, you hear these stories about people downloading stuff and they think it's something and then they find out it's something else. Kind of like that game that everyone was talking about. I forget what it's called, like the Devil's Game or something like that. And you basically walk around this place and you find messages, and then you open things and there's like pictures in there. It reveals actual pictures of, like, I believe it's like child porn and stuff like that, and some messed up things like mutilated bodies, people who've been killed, and it's pretty sick, man. Just like be if you are one of those people who are curious and you go searching around on the deep web, be extremely careful, because you could die. But anyway, my question to all of you for question of the day is, do you believe this is a true story or not? I don't actually know. I didn't really look that much into it. I just read the creepypasta and that was it. But do you believe it's a true story? I mean, I've heard stories that are true that are similar, so it could be. But let me know what you guys think. That is question of the day. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please slap a like on it. Let's see if we can go for 500 billion likes on this video. I would really appreciate that. And if you guys didn't see my previous video, which was a story on Laughing Jack, the creepypasta, so if you guys want to see that, be sure to click here on the outro when it comes on and you can watch that. Or if you just want to watch another random video, you can click the side of the outro and it will do that too. But remember the most important thing of all, guys, chase your dreams. I love you all. Don't let anybody bring you down, and I'll see you back here tomorrow for another video. Peace out.